Hello.
How you doing?
Hi, I'm fine, thanks. And you?
I'm very well, thank you.
Awesome.
How's your week been?
Oh, so far so good.
Oh, that's good.
And what's about your week?
Mate, not too bad. Probably haven't been setting the world on fire with my StarCraft this week, I'm afraid, but it
Okay.
hasn't been too bad. I think I've played. Let me have a look. I think I've played about six multiplayer games or six 1v1 since last week. And I've. Hang on. Just let me get this up. Lost 2, 1, 2. Lost 1-4, lost 4. So it's a bit of a mixed bag. And so some of my losses, I wouldn't mind showing you the ones from yesterday and today, because neither of them were particularly very good on my part.
I see you have a very long game we can watch.
Yeah, which one's that? So yesterday.
Cerulean Fall 2 days ago, 20 minutes. That seems
Yes.
promising.
Well, I think I won that game because I was pretty. Actually, it's really full. Sorry,
Against
so does it
Terran.
against Billy the Kid?
Let me check again.
Is that the one? 20 minutes, 47 seconds.
Yeah, seems good.
All right, you want to watch that one?
It would be a longer game. You typically have games around 10 minutes, 12 minutes, so
Yes.
that's where we did talk a lot about the last few sessions, so you basically know what to do there. Most of the time it will be some missed part of scouting or not macroing enough or stuff like that, I guess. But a long game tends to be very interesting and very challenging as well. And if you have time after that, we can watch off the other games as well. So,
Okay, no worries.
yeah, let me go into group and then join your game. And then I give you the leader here. I hope that works.
I think that's all okay. Let's just see if you show up in the lobby.
I hope so, but I don't think that it works like that. That's the problem.
It's still saying waiting for other party now.
Yeah. Okay, I will just restart the game and I think you need to wait until I am in your group before you open
Yeah,
the
sorry
replay.
about that.
I don't know why Blizzard hasn't done anything about that. Maybe it's too much for them for the benefit, but it would be nice. But it's still interesting if you see the game is how old? 8 years now? I think 2010 it came out.
Yeah, okay.
I guess. And still things you could improve. So let's see. So invite to party, that's the first step. And then I promote you to the leader. Yes.
So I'm good to go now.
Yep. Then I can accept, and then I should be in the lobby. And then you can make
There
me
we
host,
go.
and then, yeah. Okay.
Promote to leader.
Yep, to lobby host.
Oh, sorry.
Okay, now. Nice. Okay. So this was against a Terran. Interesting.
So I've been getting smashed. So the two games I've lost in the last 2 days that I'm still a
Okay.
little bit salty about are both games versus Terrans.
Yes.
And particularly this map is a good map for them dropping as well, because there's, you
Oh
know,
yeah,
where your
true.
main base is, it's really big and.
I
So I
see where
think.
this is going. So let's have a look here. Let me just get that on. Okay. So, right. Okay. So let's see. Gateway 1, scouting. Ah, okay. Different opening. Not the two gateways anymore.
No, it is still the two gateways, I think.
Okay.
Yep.
Hmm.
It's normally first gateway and then the two gases.
Yep, okay, I see. So you still are not getting the salad so far.
And especially on a map like this, because there's a Reaper path. Reapers always hammer me, and a Zealot just seems to run after them doing nothing, whereas if I can get the two Stalkers out pretty quickly,
yes,
I chrono them if I'm getting hammered by a Reaper.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so we did the gas deal. As long as you don't lose the Zealot early on to the Reaper, you should be fine having it. It just acts as a meat shield for your Stalker, so you can micro them a little bit better. And
okay.
In this game, he didn't go for a Reaper. Just imagine him. If you would have gotten the salad in this game, let's see how far it takes. Let's see. Okay, so your gateway would finish right now. So you could start the salad. I think the salad takes roughly 30 seconds. I don't know exactly how long it takes the salad to being produced. So at minute 2 you would be ready. If you don't chrono it out. So right now you could move across the map with the salad. And probably it would hit at 230 or 240. On the opponent's base, and you would see that he doesn't have a Reaper. So the salad, if you go for this build, you have the salad for not only making the Reaper, keeping the Reaper busy, but if he doesn't go for a Reaper at all, you will also scout it. In this case, you would be able potentially to kill one SCV or kill some of his depots or at least damage them. And you would see that it's mostly safe to move across with the Stalker then as well. So let's see what happens here. Okay, at least you're moving out with the Stalker. I like that. So your Zealot in this case could have delayed or even cancelled the bunker. And it would have lined out so perfectly for you, because not only would you be able to get in and delay his commands, you could have potentially dealt so much damage here. Just imagine, you see, he has Marines attacking your gas geyser, which you stole, so that's nice. You also see that he doesn't have gotten a orbital command center yet, he's just have the normal command center, so his economy is not very good, to be honest. Your Zealot could have delayed or even cancelled the bunker, and with that your Stalker could have come in. So you would have delayed his command center by a lot, potentially killed some Marines if he would have moved down. You could have killed two supply depots in the process as well, and it wouldn't have cost you basically anything. So that's like 400 to 500 minerals damage plus the time. That's not bad, especially if you can time it with the gas steel. So I would try to just try it out some games and get a feeling for it. He doesn't even have a wall. LOL. Okay, nice. Okay, not even a wall off. So it's not that bad. If you would have walled in correctly, you wouldn't have been able to get in with the stalker. So that's why I was tempting for the Saladin. Yeah, that's exactly the thing now. So now his bunker is there. You can't get in, and you can't really deal any damage, but you could have. Okay. So back at home, Nexus again. Okay. Yes, you have lots of minerals. So that's still something you still are doing the custom games, I guess. Okay. Are they do you have the feeling they are helping you out with the macro and the maxing out and so on?
Yes,
Okay. So I would definitely keep that on and just do this more and more. The good thing with the custom games is you don't have to worry about your army or your scouting or anything. You can really focus on your macro, on spending your money. So that's good. I also like that you're getting additional pylons. So in this game, what I like so far is you have now with the second pylon, you have two pylons here for the robotics facility. With the pylon up your nexus, you have even three there. So the gateway above your nexus has two pylons powering, and left you have one pylon powering one gateway. If the pylon would be killed, you still would have the cybernetics core, which is not the most important part here, so but it's okay. You have the salad wall, I guess it is. Yeah, it seems solid. I think the salad can't get up the top left-hand mineral field between the gas guys and the pylon, so it's a really complete wall, I guess, which is awesome. So that's a really good wall in my opinion. That's a really, really well-rounded wall to catch any Reaper going in with Adept or Stalker. And your pylon spread is really good. What you later on want to do, so I like that pylon which I pinged. However, this pylon could also be more in the center or to the outer of your main base to grant more vision if drops would come. So that's
I think
something
I
you could
do.
do.
Normally, once I've got the base up and going, I do start to spread them around a bit
Yes.
more, but especially
Yes.
when I'm playing Terrans, I've been trying to keep it really tight
Yep.
for the first few minutes at least.
It makes sense, yes. But later on you want to get that vision. But so far this is way better on your pylon spread and energy power energy management than the last games we watched. So I like that. Only thing is you have 200 energy on your Nexus, so you need a little bit to improve your chrono boosting. It is okay to save some chrono boost at some time if you want to save it for a special timing. For example, if you want to get blink, I think therefore if you want to get a blink timing attack, then you save the chrono boost a little bit, but normally it should never reach 200. So try to spend it. Even if you are over probing, you can then resaturate as soon as the Nexus finishes. Okay, there's the robotics bay. That's not bad at all. I like that. Okay. Yes, you definitely could chrono boost your probes there. Would make sense. He scans. Where does he scan? He scans
Yeah, he did a
himself.
really good job to find my observer.
Ah, I see. Okay, that's nice. But your observer saw how did it die?
I think I got a pretty good scout off
So
first.
you go in. Du -du 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 -du, du -du 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 Okay. Let me see if you could have saved it.
I
So the
thought if I saw him
observer
coming.
232. Okay.
Just kept heading right there.
Yes. So you did too many turns, I guess. I think that turn,
Yep.
Yeah, and then the turn back was too much. Maybe you could have done it, but at least you got a scout, so you know potentially Stim is coming up. You see the engineering bay, the starport, the tech lab on the factory for tanks, of course, as usual. So that's nice for you to see. But as soon as you lost, okay, you remake one, and that's where you also, yeah, there's your chrono boost. Okay, that's good. Okay. Definitely resaturate your base as soon as possible. That's very important. Yeah. There you go.
Oh, there we go.
Yeah, it's a little bit late, but it's okay.
I have been trying to focus on that because I've been really bad at it.
It limits your production so much. You are crippling yourself. I know you don't see it, but I bet somewhere in the internet you can find the calculation on how much having 24 probes instead of them spread out of the bases will limit your production and your income. Okay. Yeah. So you definitely need to work on your macro mechanics here, taking the bases earlier. I know with the kind of build you play, you are slower in getting your Nexi and such. But when you are getting your Nexi, normally you get your Nexus, I think it's around 130 or at least the 2 minute mark. In your games, when you tend to go to warp gate and then the robotics facility, you normally need to deal damage, like real damage. Be super aggressive, don't lose anything, because your Nexus will be 2 minutes to 2 minutes and 30 seconds later, and this translates throughout the game, so all your timings with your macro will be delayed by that amount. So instead of having the third Nexus by 4:30, you should have it at like the 7 minute mark, or 6:30 if you can, if you have good spendings with your chrono boost and your probes. So that would be the amount where you now should be getting the Nexus. And yes, if you have two Nexus, I think you can ditch the fourth gateway so far. You don't need it right now. Rather spend it on a Nexus, a third one, so that you can boost the income. As soon as you have three Nexi up and running, completely saturated, that's the time when you want to go up to 7 or 8 gateways. Normally, if you have full saturation with your both Nexi, and you have 4 gateways and a robotics facility and spend your chrono boost, you won't have enough income for your upgrades. So you need to skip one production cycle for it, I guess. Or to get the Nexus done. So it is a little bit smoother if you ditch the fourth gateway, but it's not a mistake or anything, just a minor detail here. You could have the Nexus earlier. Okay, so he's expanding here, getting another command center. You have only, oh no, you have 3 observer. Okay, one is patrolling there, that's nice. One is there, one is there. Okay, so that's,
I keep getting dropped, so I'll just be,
yes,
putting these observers out.
You should have that. So having 3 to 5 observer would be fine. And definitely you want to have one on his ramp or army. I know he scanned it one time, but it was because he was moving around with it and he saw it. And the sensor tower doesn't detect the observer. So,
okay.
Yeah, you would be totally, you could have the observer right on top of it. He wouldn't see it. Only the missile turrets will detect, or the Raven. Or the scan, of course. So, just in case, you can have an observer there, it doesn't harm it. He won't see it. Also, DTs, he won't see, he won't even know they are there. Only if there would be detection as well, he would get those little red dots to spot them, but he has no detection. So, yeah. Because as you can see, you're going for Colossus again against tanks, and it can work, but it's not the most ideal. So if you would see that, then you want to switch into most likely Archon Charge Lord, Archon Charge Lord, I think, with storms. That would be what you want to do. So potentially, I think in this game you could have scouted it even before you get the robotics bay down. So that you can just switch into Twilight Council immediately instead of it. Get your charge lots on the way. Stop making Stalker. You can have Stalker against this style if he wants to drop you. Then it's not bad to have four Stalker at each base to intercept incoming drops. So having those Stalker you have now and split them amongst your bases would be totally okay, so that you can intercept drops and prevent them from happening. But it's not necessary. You also can have Zealots somewhere scattered around your bases. Anytime he's unloading, he will, especially if you have shield batteries somewhere scattered around your base. So later in the late game, if you have enough money, of course, what you most likely will do, like with your pylon spread at your main base, get one or two shield batteries somewhere, get one or two cannons, and have one or two Zealots somewhere. This will get you enough time to react if he still wants to drop. Most of the time, the Terran is like, ah, I shouldn't drop unless he comes in with like six medivacs or so. But if it's only one or two, he will lose all his units, because shield battery, cannon, and charge lot will just defend it from happening. Okay, so let's see. Okay, so the pylon spread is really good. You don't have just one pylon powering everything, unless that one. But so far, that's way better than the previous games we watched last time. So at the 10-minute mark, you could get the next Nexus. You're just getting now the third one, which is like 3 minutes late, maybe even four. The thing is, if you imagine, just for you to realize maybe, if you would hit the timings, you should. Of course, you are now in Silver League, everything fine, but just to see the potential you have, you could now be on maxed out army, sitting on four Zeterate bases and having 2-2 against his army. So you would be double the amount of his army with double the upgrades he got. You could just A move into him and straight win if you would get your macro perfectly done. Of course, perfectly is something not even professionals get done, because they get harassed, they have to do a lot of stuff, but in an ideal situation, you could just A move across the map and instantaneously win without even looking at your army. Okay. So let's see, where are you heading now? You have now the six gateways. You could go up to seven, as we said. Okay. Ah, you have one observer. Okay. That's not the ideal position for your observer, of course, but at least you have one at his side. That's something. I am a little bit worried about your vision, because if he would to choose to attack you now, you wouldn't see it. Especially against Terran, if they have siege tanks and Liberator, which this guy has, like seven siege tanks for Liberator. That's not too bad. Eight, in fact, eight tanks. What he could do, and you wouldn't even see it, he could move out right here, potentially. Siege up his Liberator, siege his tanks, and threaten your base.
I think that's exactly what he does.
Okay,
that's
okay,
exactly what he does.
Okay. That's why I mention it, and you wouldn't even notice until he did it, and then you are forced to go in. And against someone who has siege tanks, you always want to prevent that from happening. So, first thing is scatter around some pylons somewhere. It doesn't matter where they are. You can have them somewhere on the map. It doesn't matter, but have them somewhere. Maybe even there. It doesn't matter. Those are all positions where you could have pylons right now. Of course, don't have all on those positions pylons right now. That would be a little bit too much for your economy currently. But one, two, or three pylons would be nice. So that you can attack him. Especially if you would stop going Stalker. You have way too many Stalker without Blink. You don't have Blink. That's not good. If you would go for Charge Lord, Immortal Archon, Storm, whatever. You also have you have the Twilight Counter. So exactly what you're getting now here, the Dark Shrine, is what you want. The Dark Shrine. And then you can attack. You need to have maybe a Salad or a Stalker or something along his pathway. So if you get in his mindset, where would he attack right now? It would be your third base, potentially, if he doesn't want to drop and he doesn't have any dropships. So third base would be attacked. So it would come from the left hand side, means you should have a Salad. Let's jump back a little bit. You should have a Salad right here. Out of vision of his sensor tower, but if he moves out, you see it and you can react in time. Maybe have a Salad on that ramp as well. You can have probes there if you have enough. On patrol command, or even get a pylon, it doesn't matter. Or an observer, just that you have some vision on what's going on. And as always, if you have then the pylon and he moves out, warp in some Salads. If you have the charge lords and one or two DTs, he won't scan for them, and you can kill bases with it. You could potentially pair this so sneaky. If you would have a pylon on the left top side and the right middle side, center side, two pylons scattered there, and he moves out and you see it. And on both pylons, you warp in three Salads and one DT. And you attack his third base and his fourth base at the same time. Believe me, you will kill dozens of SCVs, potentially even kill a command center, and he needs to react. So either he all-ins you, and that's where you can force the win out of him if your macro is good. Because he's out of the map. So either way, he can go for it, stick with his attack, try to win from there, then he's all-in. Or he can pull back, which grants you the opportunity to move your army to some location where you want and to intercept it when it wants to move out again. And because you are attacking on two fronts at the same time, he most likely will not split his army. Most people won't do it. So you still deal a lot of damage. So he has 2-2 now. And you can see his macro is looking not too bad. He has a healthy SCV count. He's maybe overdoing them a little bit.
He's got a lot.
Yeah, but it's fine as long as he produces. So now he moves out. Du-du-du-du-du. Okay. So you're getting blinked now, 2-2. You have the DTs. Okay. Okay. So far, not too bad. There comes the scan. So he doesn't have any medivacs. That's interesting. Okay. But yes, now he sees just slowly forward. And the tanks. Okay. I would have been better with Blink, but you still crushed it somehow, so that's good for you. Now you should move across the map instantaneously. Because you're a Protoss, you do one warp in, as much as you can, your gateways are all up. You have enough to warp in, just get whatever you want and move across the map. Don't give him time to replenish. So if you win once, if this time, if you have army left, and this is still considered an army, not the biggest one, but at least you have more than two Zealots and one observer. Move across the map. He is down now 50-40 army supply. You can win this right here if you would go across the map and just kill him. So don't wait for him to go in again. Take the initiative, attack him. He doesn't have anything to deal with your attack. And the good thing is, if you attack and you see you can't break him, just pull back. Move around, maybe threaten another base. Try to be a little bit active with your army. I think that's why you lost this game. Partial, of course, macro could have been better. But after the one time you attacked, you gave him time to replenish. I like that you have 3-3. That's good. That's really good. You have the gases saturated.
Here,
yeah.
To be making lots of bloody archons to go with charge lots, but I
yeah.
Didn't have the economy.
You have the gas at least. Where's your Templar Archive? Oh.
Shrine instead.
Okay. Yeah. Templar Archive would have been better in this case. To dump your gas. At some point, you of course should have all options available to you. So you should have the Fleet Beacon, the Twilight Council, the Templar Archive, Robotics Facility, Robotics Bay. You should have everything. Okay, that's where he strikes. And you can't move into that. You simply cannot. It's impossible for you to do this. If you move in right now there, Your buildings and the way the map is shaped will work so heavily against you. The only option you have is move around and try to strike from the back. I like that you have on the top side this warp prison with the Zealots. What you should also do, in this case he has sadly the pla-
I should have put a DT in there as well.
Yes, that's the first thing. Very good. But your warp prism should move to his natural and warp in there again. So you threaten two bases. Yes, this, it's sad that he has now the planetary fortress, because for so long this was just a command center. Now the Zealots won't have any chance of dealing damage to him. So having adepts or stalker behind the mineral line would have been better, but normally you just go for Zealots. That's the way to go. But yeah, DTs. If he has a turret, right click on the turret, try to kill it as soon as possible. So that you at least have a counterattack. You could also, with the warp prism, if he doesn't have turrets, he has scattered around his facilities quite a lot, but you could also move into the main base and just warp in 10 Zealots and 2 DTs and wreck his whole main base. Because he's maxed out, he can't produce anything. So, yeah, but I like the idea of the warp prism. Just be more aggressive with it. And now it's exactly what you do. You move in, you feel the urge to defend what you can't. Oh no, you go about around. Okay, that's smart. So you should blink on top of this stuff, but still it's a very difficult situation to clear. The Zealots did a good job. It's really close here. I think if you would have... Wait, okay. So first of all, of course, if you would have seen it, you could have intercepted it.
Yeah, if I could have got those tanks and liberators before they see
yes,
it.
Yes. Okay, so you moved there now. And all you would need to do now is have the Zealots on A move. Don't micro them at all. You have the all army here. For the attack move, that's fine. If you attack move right here now in the center of his army, the Zealots will find their target, so you don't need to worry about them. All you need to do potentially is have the Stalker blink, maybe also on top of the tanks as soon as possible. And then you only micro the Colossus. You have two left now, so that's not too much. You can micro them if they get targeted, or you can choose with the Stalker to focus fire tanks and Liberator. If you don't fight in liberation zones, you focus tanks first. If you fight in liberation zones, attack the Liberators first. That's all you need to do. But what you do, if you look closely at your Zealots, you will see that they will.
I'm doing a status step into the
enemy. Yeah. With the Zealots. And so they are. They want to attack something, but you pull them back every time you stutter step.
Yeah.
So now the Zealots move. You see how the Zealots are moving away from the tanks and marines?
Yeah.
And that's where you lose a lot of damage. Of course, it's unfortunate that they clump up so heavily that the tanks can kill them. But you didn't use your blink as well. And now you lost a lot of income. A lot of probes died. So, yeah, your army is bruised. I guess that's potentially game then. Upgrade-wise, it was looking quite good for you. Unfortunately, the Warp Prism didn't deal too much damage. So now you move in. If he only has tanks, I would only go in with Zealots. So that your Stalker Immortal are not taking any damage. They don't need to. The Zealots will clear. If it's really only tanks, you can just go in with Zealots. So you prevent damage from happening. But here, this is basically game. Yeah. There he goes. Okay, so I think the basic lesson of that game is, if you win a fight decisively, attack him. In this game, that definitely was the case. Still, of course, your macro, your base taking, gas saturation, Twilight Council, Charge Lord Archon instead of Stalker, get your blink if you have them, etc. pp. But aside from that, you had this game. And you could have easily won it if you just attacked him after he wasted his army on you. His attack wasn't too bad, but he hadn't any Marauder, any Medivacs. So that's... he wants to have Medivacs. You were up 40 army supply, upgrades were even, I guess, so you definitely could have dealt a lot of damage and potentially won from there. It could have been completely the other way around. So from the basic plan, what I see, you currently are gold level, like he is. It's just a little bit decision making and having the courage to just go for it if you have the opportunity. I like your pylon spread. That was, in this game, it was really good. The Reaper wall was really good. The warp prism, I like the idea. You can supplement it with pylons. If you have some pylons, if you have two or three pylons scattered around the map, and you have the warp prism, you can strike at three sides at the same time. If he's not prepared for that, and you still have your army left as a fourth option. That's a lot of options you give yourself if you have those pylons.
Yep. Alright, can I show you another one I lost yesterday? It's only 13 minutes.
Yep,
but,
yep, of course.
So, last couple of games, it's just a Terrence. I'm just really struggling to play against Terrence.
I see. I think most of it comes down to army composition.
Yep.
Oh, again, Cerulean Fall.
Yeah. So can you go straight into Charge Lord Archon Immortal?
If you see that he's going for Marine Tank, definitely, yes. You should always go for sentries, of course, to split his marines into half.
Yeah.
So if you do that, the nice thing about sentries is if you play Charge Lord Archon, you can have Immortal, you don't need too many of them, but most composition would be just Charge Lord Archon with Storm. And of course then the sentries, because what the sentries does is you have the Guardian Shield for soaking up damage of the Marines, but you have also the possibility to go for force fields, and you should use this. So if you can split his army in half, your Charge Lords will prevent them, so they can corner them, and the tanks will deal splash damage onto the Marines itself. As soon as you have killed those Marines, you split, pull back, you dealt enough damage, and wait for it to go, for the force field to go away. If you have Archons, you can just kill your own force fields then, because Archons are massive units and they kill force fields immediately if they move onto it. And then the Charge Lords can go further and attack the tanks. But you can go immediately into Charge Lord Archons if you see it. You just need to be careful that you scout correctly. If he goes for Liberator, then you need something that can deal with it. Either have Tempest later on, or have some Blink Stalker to take them out step by step. If he doesn't have many Liberator, you can overwhelm him and just ignore them if you move behind them so that they don't have the circle on your army. Yes, but if you scout it, I would go for Charge Lord Archon. It is a very strong army composition. The only thing that counters it quite hard is if he goes for a lot of Widow Mines. Then you need to switch, of course. Or not go in with all your army at once, but have some Zealots suicide into the Widow Mines and then have the rest of your army. You could also tank with your Archons, but nah, not the best idea. But against tanks and Marines, I would go for a Charge Lord Archon. Have some force fields, yeah. Okay, so in this game, you don't have the wall, the blocking wall completely. There's a small gap there. And there's the Reaper, look at it!
Stupid Reaper.
Yeah. Yes, and that's why he can escape. Exactly, that's the thing. Yeah, it's a little bit unfortunate. Let's see how the Reaper went across the map. I want to see it. Where is it? Where is the Reaper? Okay, I think with the Zealot you could have prevented that from happening. You could have the Zealot. It takes the Reaper a long time to kill the Zealot, so they would potentially have met, yeah, maybe there, I would say. And then you can use the vision blocker for the Zealot to deal with the Reaper. As we discussed last time, if you have the Zealot in the bushes, then he needs to go in, and if he goes in, he goes near your Zealot, so your Zealot can attack. If he goes out, he can't attack it, so he has to spend some time with the Zealot, or go around it and ignore it. If he ignores it, you can have the Zealot attack his supply depot and be annoying there, so he needs to react and pull SCVs to repair it. If he goes for a reactor, that gives you so much time to deal real damage, and you still have the stalker then back at home, and you can have one stalker right there, one stalker at your ramp, and be prepared for the Reaper. So I definitely would say try to sell it as soon as the gateway finishes the first one. So here it comes in. Du-du-du-du-dum. And it deals so much damage because you're not saturating your gases just now. There you go. Okay. Little bit of oversaturation going on here. Still want to have the Nexus. Let's see when you figure it out. Supply capped as well? Oof, that's a tough game for you. Okay. So what are you trying in this game? You're still on one base. For what were you scared of?
I
That you.
sent his Reaper in, so I thought I'm getting aggression here.
Okay.
And he had a whole, and so I've got my observer on the other side, and he's got Marines and medevacs there, so I was thinking, okay, he's going to send over a drop.
Okay.
So just turtle up till he does that, try to take out the drop, and then expand behind it. But I
Okay.
don't think he does drop me for ages.
No, he just getting some army. Oh, don't attack your own pylon.
I had to. He was in the way of my Nexus.
Oh, okay, I
Positioned
see.
the pylon in a good spot to start with.
Okay. Oh no, I see. Yeah, in this game a lot of is going wrong for you. So now he goes in for the drop. There's the drop coming. And he's happy to see that you're just now getting your second base. Okay. Yeah, I guess in this game it's most likely to just be your macro that is limiting you so much. Interestingly, you are still in the game and not far behind in terms of supply. So that's very strange.
I think I'm making too many units and buildings and shit in this early and mid game, because I
Yes.
seem to stay ahead in supply up until about the 8 minute mark in just about every game I play, and then I still lose them. So instead of building all the buildings and units, I need to be doing Nexus earlier.
Exactly. Normally you don't need to be exactly on par with his army supply. If you see him moving out, that's where you need to start. I mean, of course, at some point you always should start to warp and stuff, but I have seen games where the Protoss was behind half the army supply. So the Terran was on 60 army supply, the Protoss was on 20. And then the Terran moves out, but by the time he arrives at the third base of the Protoss had 60 army supply to counter the attack because he just had the timings correctly with the gateways and the warp instant. So he could defend without sacrificing too much of his economy. I still would say go for the double Stargate. It is okay, but be aggressive. Get the Zealot. Move across the map. If you see the Reaper, you can deal with it. I don't think you need the robotics facility that early. It should be fine to get it after the Nexus as well. Especially if you are aggressive, you can dictate what he's going. If he wants to go for tanks, for example, it takes him too long. So if you are aggressive with your opening, he needs to make units. So he will go for a cyclone. Cyclones are strong early on, will be useless later on. So you dealt already damage because he doesn't have the tank he wants. Stuff like that. You can dictate a little bit his game. You can see what he's going for. You can deal damage. Yeah. I need to have a look for a good two gateway build order. I'm not really sure about the robotics facility that before the Nexus. If you are not aggressive, it can work, I guess. It's very safe, but I think it's too safe. Two gateways. If you see most Protoss early on, just play one gateway, for two bases. Some are that greedy that they still have just one gateway and one robotics facility if they take their Nexus at the minute 4:30. And it works. If they scout correctly, of course, and don't get all in. But they adapt if they see it. So you could play more greedy, I guess, if you are active enough on the map. And of course, if you get that mini stalker, get blink. You need blink. Blink is so important. Right now you're getting salad charge and you have no salad at all. That's not so great. Okay, there he moves in. Just imagine he would have blink right now. At least you could blink on top of his army. Yeah, he just will kill you, I guess. Yes, okay. What was the army size? You were behind a little bit in army. Did you see him moving out? Yes, so your observer is right there.
Yep.
Yeah.
Whether I was actually looking at the right moment, though, I can't remember because my army's totally out of position here, so I don't think I actually did see it.
Yeah. You need to watch the minimap for that as well, sometimes. I mean, it takes him. How long does it take him? How many seconds do you have? I know it's a lot, but potentially, let's slow down. I want to see when he's going for it. How much time do you have to see it? So there are the cyclones. So here he goes. 2, 3, 4, 5. At least you saw some movement. Yes, you have enough time. So if you watch on the minimum every 10 to 20 seconds, at least it gives you better chances of catching it. And then you can react to it. Of course, as well, again, but in this game, you turtled up way too much. But pylons and vision and so on. And the usual stuff, you know. And then he just can crush you.
So this guy managed to get... So he's 10 supply ahead of me right now.
Yeah.
Even though I've got 13 more probes. Than
yes.
How does that work? Is that just mules? How can he have more supply at this point in the game when I've got heaps more harvesters than he does?
One thing is of course your saturation, because your bases are super late in this game. Mules do have a part in it as well. I think a mule is worth 4 to 6 SCVs.
Wow.
Yes, I think it's 4 now. It was used to be 6. I think now it's 4. But yes, so he can. Of course, in this game, as you can see, he didn't use too many mules. He used a lot of supply cooldowns, which is not good at all, but okay. And then, of course, macro. I think if you would have had Blink and Blink on top of his army, potentially you could have won this engagement. Maybe not, but at least the chances would have been way better. His Widowmines are not built currently, and you would be on top of the tanks. It would have been super close, of course, but at least closer than that. There goes the Widowmines, and yeah, that's GG. Yeah, so basic stuff here with the scouting army composition. And in this game, you turtled very heavily. I like the 20 minutes game better. It was really better. I think you can get away. I will have to search for a build order that has those two gateways, but I'm certain that you don't get the robotics that early unless you want to be playing a one base all in. So try to get the salad out and be active with it. Move across the map with the stalker, scout him, pressure him, and skip the. I think you can. You can go for only one gas as well early on, because you don't have the robotics, and then your nexus will be so much earlier, and then you can go for the robotics, get the second gas, and go back to your normal economy, to your normal build order, but you are just faster with your income, and your third nexus can be thrown down then at like minute 6 or 6:30, which is late in comparison to professional games, but for you it's way earlier than minute 10, so that should be an improvement already. So I would really try to start doing that, and then scatter around the pylons, warp in DTs and salads and so on. But I think that's what will get you better if you start doing that.
Goal for the week. Nexus at 2.5 minutes and 6 minutes instead of 4 minutes and 10 minutes.
Yes, try it. I would really skip the robotics. Yeah, and the second gas, just get one. Should be fine. Saturate it completely with three probes instead of two because you need it. Get the salad, get the two stalker, move across the map, apply pressure, get your nexus, and then go back to robotics. Don't go up to four gateways, go up only to three, first of all. Saturate your bases, warp in whenever you can, because with the economy you can warp in every 30 seconds stuff, which you need to do. Maybe get one or two sentries for the hallucinated phoenix and the force fields. Then your nexus, and then gateway explosion and splash tag, like Colossus, or if you scouted, go into Charge Lord Archon Storm. And I think that should move, be way better for you if you can get it done. It needs some practice, but if you get to it, you can overwhelm your enemy better. And if you take a decisive engagement win, attack him. Just move across the map. And if you have those proxy pylons, warp in there then as well to keep him on multiple fronts. If you do this, you will be gold in no time.
No worries. Okay. Well, mate, thank you very much for that, and I'll talk to you next week.
Awesome. I'm looking forward to it.
Thanks a lot. I appreciate it, mate. Talk soon.
Okay. So, best of luck on the ladder. Have a nice day, and we see us then. Bye. Heyo there. Thank you for watching. If you'd like to support me, simply hit the thumbs up button. Do you have any wishes, feedback or suggestions? Put them into the comments below. You may also subscribe if you're new to the channel. I wish you a wonderful and stress-free day. Take care. Bye bye. Thank you.